Today I would like to share with you some basic concepts about tambour embroidery. If you start with tambour embroidery, the whole idea seems a little bit complicated because you are working on a frame, you're working with beads and a hook, and how does it work and how does it come together? It's quite confusing. It might be quite confusing, especially if you know that there are other embroidery techniques like ari embroidery, which also works with a hook and also with beads and sequins, and works from the top as well as where the tambour embroidery works from the bottom. So it is quite confusing. So today I would like to show you a little bit the differences in how it works and the basic tools that you need for tambour embroidery. So tambour embroidery, why is it called tambour? It's because the frame you work on, it's like this. It's a wooden frame with four separate pieces, and they are put together and they put tension on the fabric. You see the fabric is really very flat, very well put tension on, which makes it like a tambour, which is a French word for drums. And the drum is very tight, and then you can play the drums. And here it's almost like if you play the drums on your frame. And why do you need this tension in your fabric on the tambour frame? That's because you work with a needle that's called the tambour hook. It is a very, very small crochet in a holder, so it is a separate needle which is put in the holder. And the special thing which you really have to keep in mind is that you place the hook of the needle at the side of the knob, then you fix it. It's strongly held in the holder. So you work with the tambour on the frame, on the tambour, and the hook goes through the fabric down and up and down and up again. And the tricky thing is that if you go in the fabric and you go just straight up and you do like this, you damage the fabric, you cut the fibers of the fabric, which is not good. But when it is really tight, it becomes quite easy to, with very small movement of your hand and with the needle, to push aside the fibers of the fabric and to get the hook out without damaging the fibers. That's very important, and that's actually almost only possible when the fabric is very tight, and it works the fastest when it is really tight. So that's why you work on the tambour frame and you need it like this. The tambour hook is a really great way to do embroidery, and the frame is loose. So if you look at this frame here, you see some of my embroideries which I have done, and the strange thing about the hook is that if you work beads and sequins, they go on the downside of the frame. So if this is my right side here, I can do the embroidery with the embroidery needle, like the normal needle that you know, and you just see what you do on the right side. But if I will use the tambour hook with beads and sequins, they are on the downside. So it is very convenient if the frame is not fixed to a table, not fixed to any holder, but it is like this, because then you can flip the frame to check on yourself on the other side of the fabric if your beads and sequins are right into place. So what you need your large frame, you need something to put your frame on. These are trestles that I bought at a huge store that everyone knows from Sweden. And the nice thing about these ones are that they are adjustable in size. So sometimes you just want to sit up more straight while you work. Other times you are more relaxed. And depending on how you feel or what technique you use, it is very convenient to adapt the height of the trestles so you work easily. If you have several people working on the same place, it is good because not everyone is as big as the other one, so then people, large and smaller people, can work on the same trestles easily. But there are also very cheap trestles, or you can even use a chair like this and put it on the on top of the chair. So, or on top of a table, or a chair and a table, or anything. You can find a way to put it on, but it needs to be stable. So you can put your weight of your arms on it and you can really concentrate while working. So that's about the frame. And for the frame, you put in the fabric and you need the twill tapes. That's this tape. It's the tape with the V in it. You need the twill tapes to put the fabric, to put strain on the fabric in this direction. And you need 2 times 5 meters. That's quite a lot, but it goes like back and forth on the sides. And that's about the length that you need most of the time. So that's what you really need. Then another thing, you need the hook, the special holder and the hook. The most used size of the needle is size 80. You need a bobbin holder, that's a small wooden tool. Where do you use it? You do use it to place your spool on. There is something really strange about tambour embroidery, and that is the fact that normally if you would sew or embroider, you cut off a thread, you put it in your needle, and you start, you make a knot or something like that, or a starting point, and then you start embroidering. That's the normal way to do it, yes, right? With tambour, it's different. You work from your bobbin straight onto the fabric. So, for example, here we have the bobbin with the thread, and I have some beads here. And if I would start embroidering, I would bring the thread down, bring it up with the needle and start embroidering. And only when I'm finished with the embroidery, only then I cut off the thread. So you work from your bobbin. And as you have seen, the fabric is quite tense. And if you place a bobbin like this on the fabric, it will roll away easily. That's not convenient. So the bobbin holder makes life far better when doing tambour embroidery. It's a simple tool, but really very convenient. That's about that part. Then what you need is a piece of cork. Why? The tambour needle is quite sharp. So by putting it in a cork while you are not working with it, you prevent your fabric from any damage, you prevent your hands, your eyes, your legs, everything from damage from this sharp point. And then last but not least, you need a plate like this. This is called a beading plate. It's a very small, really beautiful round plate with a small trim here. And if you have some loose materials, you can put it on and it will not roll away. If it's on the fabric, it will roll away and on the ground. If you place it on a plate like this, it's easy to keep it together. Especially for making a beading plate like this. We have put up a tutorial for you, and in the notes below this video, you will find the link to it in the Etsy shop where you can buy it. Because I have quite some experience making these beading plates, and it is a tricky thing to do. It's very doable, but you have to know some small things to make it look better and perform in the way you want it to perform, right? So actually, this is all about the basic tools that you need for tambour embroidery. It's the frame, the trestles, the bobbin holder, the beading plate, the tambour hook, and your twill tapes for the fabric. So hope to see you next time. If you like this video, please hit the heart button here below the video, of the thumbs up. And if you would not to miss any other video, subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends. And I hope to see you back. If you have any question, put a comment in below and I would be happy to answer it. Bye for now.